Greetings, boxing fans. This is Haplotype Zero with a video prediction on the upcoming rematch of Cotto and Margarito this Saturday. My goal with all my videos is to point out insights and observations that other people have not yet pointed out. And of course, I have not seen every other YouTube video out there. I've always been a fan of Miguel Cotto since I saw him compete in the Olympic Games, and I knew that he would be possibly the successor to the crown as far as Puerto Rican fighters go. Of course, I should note that my mom is from Puerto Rico, therefore I have a rooting interest in Puerto Rican fighters. Though I think that Cotto, is a highly skilled and well-trained athlete, and I like his demeanor. It's pretty much everything about him I like. Even if he wasn't Puerto Rican, I would be a fan of his fighting style, his demeanor, his character, and how he handles himself in the ring and outside the ring. So I'm not trying to put forth that I'm the most objective person when it comes to Miguel Cotto. He's one guy that I definitely favor. That being said, I'm a pretty objective person. So going back to the first fight between these two guys, I was really excited about this. Like, I didn't have anything against Margarito at that time, and I had a lot of respect for him, and I thought he was, a great pressure fighter. But of course, I was rooting for Cotto, and when the fight started, it was like a dream come true. I mean, Cotto was boxing beautifully, and to this day, if you ask me, what fight did Miguel Cotto look the best in? I would tell you it was the Cotto Margarito fight. He was just, watch those first five rounds. He was doing everything right. Margarito couldn't catch him. Yeah, he got him a couple times in the second round, but Cotto switched it up and he was slipping punches, he was dodging punches, dancing, landing combos, doing everything that you would ever want to see in boxing, and I felt like, wow, man, he's great. This is his entrance into greatness, this fight. Then, about halfway, two-thirds of the way through the fight, these little punches that Margarito was landing, it didn't look like, huge shots, just started breaking Cotto's face up. And I was thinking to myself, like, wow, Margarito must have a lot more power than it looks like he's putting on those punches, because the punches weren't like big haymakers or, really even, real solid power shots. They were just like short little punches on the inside, didn't look like much. And I'd seen Cotto take, punches from Zab Judah. I'd seen Cotto take, big punches from people. I'd seen him get rocked, and I didn't really see him get rocked against Margarito. It's just his face started breaking up, and I'd never seen that happen to the guy. So, it was real discouraging when Cotto lost that fight. When he took a knee and they threw in the towel, like, I was like depressed the next day. Like, usually I don't care that much because I'm just watching boxing because I love boxing and whatnot, but in that fight, I really did care, and it was like a huge event, and like it was, it really was the destruction of, I guess you could say, one of my heroes, and so therefore, I took it very hard, and it just didn't make sense. Something about it didn't make sense to me. Then, Margarito signs to fight Shane Mosley. Of course, at that time, around that same time, the documentary Assault in the Ring came out, and that was about, I don't want to go that far into it. It was just, synchronicity and timing, I guess, because Assault in the Ring was about, Resto and the whole hand wraps thing, and then Margarito goes in to fight Shane Mosley and gets caught trying to load his gloves. Now, look, people can say what they want, but man, sometimes people cheat when they don't even need to cheat. Sometimes people need an edge just mentally. They think they need an edge, Maybe it was his trainer, maybe it was him, but looking at the guy and what he's done since, man, I think he knew. I think it'd been something that they've been doing for a while, and of course that's just my speculation as a fan that's observing things, but and you watch him talk about it and you tell me that he doesn't contradict himself, he doesn't act guilty, and the most disgusting part about it was how he acted in regards to that during the 24/7 with Pacquiao. So he goes in, with Mosley, and of course Cotto beat Mosley. Let's not forget that. Cotto beat Mosley before he ever fought Margarito. So I'm thinking Mosley's gonna get destroyed in the fight with Margarito. And I just noticed when Mosley was walking in the ring, the look in his eyes was like, that was one of the scariest ring walks I've ever seen. Mosley just looked like he knew he was going to win that fight. And the way he won it was as spectacular, as anything that I've seen in the last few years. And, Cotto goes to fight Pacquiao. Pacquiao, beats Cotto. I think most people that know boxing expected that to happen. But I thought, Cotto did do some good things in that fight. And, he put up a decent fight for the first few rounds, and wasn't until later in the fight when he really started retreating that I think that he really gave in. And he did, let's not forget, also make it, I believe, to the 12th round, and they stopped it sort of just to sort of protect him. It wasn't like he was rocked, it wasn't like he was going down or anything like that. He was just retreating constantly, and they stopped the fight. Then, I have to talk about a little bit about Bob Arum and Margarito. Margarito, for some reason, has the favor of Bob Arum. And you would think, usually there's only one Puerto Rican star at a time. If you've noticed throughout boxing history, there's always one great Puerto Rican that's at the front of the pack of, in the top echelons of boxing. And there's always a lot of Mexican fighters. Mexico is a much bigger country than Puerto Rico. And in Mexico, they have a lot of heroes. And I think right now the number one guy is probably Saul Alvarez. But for some reason, Bob Arum loves Margarito. Even when he got caught for the hand wraps, he stood by this guy. And he talks about him all the time, and there's something. Go back and watch interviews with Bob Arum. He gives Margarito so much credit and talks about him all the time. People keep saying that, this fight's in New York, and Margarito's not going to win any close rounds on the scorecards. Don't be so sure. Bob Arum loves Margarito. I don't know why. I don't know what Margarito did for him, whatever, but I don't know, man. I just noticed. You'd think someone gets caught like that for cheating, a big time promoter like Bob Arum, who can afford it, would just say, F this guy, I'm not gonna risk my reputation, let him go to some other company. But he didn't. He stood by him the whole time. He defended him. He said he didn't know, he didn't cheat, this is preposterous, it's disgusting. It's not disgusting, man. What's disgusting is that he cheated. And getting back to his cheating, I haven't heard very many people talk about the fact that he got caught trying to cheat and did in fact kind of cheat in the Pacquiao fight. So here's this guy who's professing his innocence. He's, you know, saying, joking around, putting a big old weight on his hand, and having Robert Garcia wrap it up in the 24/7, which I thought was kind of in bad taste. You know, he's making fun of Freddie Roach having Parkinson's. And then before the Pacquiao fight, he goes to take a banned substance. Do we forget about that? I mean, this is a guy who cheats. Let's just be honest, man. When the light of the world was shining down upon him and he was fighting the number one pound for pound guy in the world, he still tried to cheat. He tried to take hydroxycut. He brought it with him to take it. And then when he couldn't take that, he drank 3 cups of coffee, which I believe you're not supposed to do. So you're dealing with a guy who is not a rule follower. Let's just put it that way. Now, that brings up a good point of, like, sometimes you need to cheat and sometimes you don't need to cheat, but cheaters cheat, man. And I think that probably if he fought Cotto straight up back then, he probably still would have beat him with that pressure. Because Cotto, you know, the way he was boxing, he was moving away. The thing that Shane Mosley did different was tie up Margarito. He would land his punches and then tie him up. Cotto would land his punches and then move away. And the way Cotto moves away, if you notice, you know, when he's fought guys that he's had to move away from, Mosley, Margarito, and Claudy, Pacquiao. He backs up all the way to the ropes. Instead of just backing up a couple steps and then throwing a couple shots, he'll back all the way up to the ropes and get himself caught on the ropes. Now, this is an interesting point because I don't know how much Cotto is talking about changing his style. I haven't heard him say anything about his fight plan going into this fight being different. You know, that he learned from watching the Mosley fight and the Pacquiao fight. He's just kind of focused on the fact that Margarito cheated. And yeah, he did, and that's all good, and, you know, gauze doesn't crack and all that. But really, he should be thinking about, okay, what am I going to do different? I'm going to tie him up like Mosley, and I'm not going to back up all the way to the, you know, across the ring like, you know, like I did against him before, because Pacquiao beat him without holding. Pacquiao beat Margarito without holding. He just didn't back up the same way. He would take a step back and then move off to the sides. Okay, so I really hope for Cotto's sake that he's watched those fights and that he's going to have a different kind of fight plan going into this. He's not just relying on the hand wraps, because he will lose again. Like, the punches may not break his face up like that, you know, but that pressure is hard to deal with for anybody. You got someone in there that's willing to die, as Margarito says he is, and I believe him. And, you know, Cotto's more pragmatic about it. But, you know, people are reading into that a little too much. I mean, Cotto has a heart, man. Don't forget who you're talking about. This is Miguel Cotto. He went 12 rounds with Pacquiao. He took a big-ass beating against Margarito and Pacquiao, and he stayed in those fights. It's not like he's going to quit if he gets hurt or gets a little cut. Look at the fight with Claudy. He got a huge cut, and he fought the whole fight. So, you know, in that little face-off thing where Max Kellerman was, like, all surprised that Cotto wasn't willing to die in the ring, I think there's no advantage in that, man. It's just Margarito trying to scare somebody or whatnot, and then, you know, his eyes all messed up. I think that could come into play. Obviously, Cotto's left hook is going to land right on that eye, you know. So my prediction for this fight is it's going to be a close fight, and if Cotto does not adjust his style, he will lose. But if Cotto has learned something from watching Pacquiao and Mosley beat Margarito, then he can win the fight. Okay, I could see him winning by knockout or by decision, but I could see also if he fights exactly the same fight, he could lose just the same way without all the injuries. He could just get beaten down. But he's not going to get beaten up with those hand wraps, at least. So hopefully Kodo wins. I'm rooting for Kodo, and thanks for watching the video.